Today we're going to be working with resistance and Bhutan. We'll need a yoga mat and a chair and indoor shoes. So let's make our way to the yoga mat, doing some stretches first. Sitting up nice and tall. We're going to inhale the arms up above the head. Try to come out, exhale again. If you inhale through your nose and if you exhale through your nose. Whenever we hold our breath. Inhale the lengthen. Exhale. And one last one. Inhale, arms up. For a long exhale again. And sun is hot. Sitting up nice and tall. Stretching out the back next. Use the shoulder extending out to balance. Using the same hand as for the head. Lengthening stretch. Staying here for three. Two. And one, slowly come up to center to the other side. Here, the shoulder extending up and arm. Using the same hand side to support the head. Stretch. If you have any stiffness in your neck, just stay here for a little bit longer. Slowly come up to center. Take an inhale to center, exhale to open the right shoulder. Only go to where you're comfortable. Inhale, center, exhale, to the other side. Slowly come back to center, chin up, half up. And then chin, two steps. Slowly come back to center, shoulder stretch, right arm up and across, pull back. Creating resistance. Chin is away from the body, looking forward. Slowly release, same arm up, leg to the first, place the palm behind the back. Use the other hand to guide that with tricep stretch. Chin up, looking forward. And release, shake it up, the other side, arm up and across, pull back. Creating resistance. Slowly release, same arm up, leg to the first, place the palm behind the back. Use the other hand to guide that. Try to bring the elbows to the back of your head. Keep the blind hands behind your back. Go ahead, finding hands. So don't worry if you're not able to bring the fingers together. Slowly release your fingers, shake it out. Hands on the shoulders, elbows in, elbows up. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Feel the pinch in shoulder blades. Opening up on hand chest. Way into a full circle. Try to bring the elbows close together. Oiling the shoulder joints. Go the other way. Slowly release, shake it up. Coming into a gentle side bend. Inhale, the arms are lengthening. Exhale, bend towards the right side. Our arms are crescent moon, looking up. Slowly come back to center, lengthening, center, exhale, to the
other side. Bending the lower arms,
top arms, and pressing you. Slowly come back to center, getting ready for a twist. Opposite hand, opposite thigh, turn a little bit back, overlooking your shoulders. Stretching our lower back muscles. The side being turned onwards.
Today, and we're going to place it on our
spot. So move it up a little bit higher on the thigh. Come lie down on your side. Bend both knees, move the feet together. We're going to go open shut like a clamshell. A few more. So it's always to listen to our body to avoid injury. Do what you can. If you need to take a break, go ahead. Have a sip of water. Join us where we can. Let's do another 3, 2, 1. Slowly release. And we're just going to go pat, pat, pat around the hip area. The meaty part, not the bony structure. Just to relieve any tension that you may have. And then we're going to move the leg further down to your calf. Same on the leg, flex the feet, lift it up. As long as you feel the resistance, it's good to go.
We're too bold to hop a car. Hitchhiking down the highway, get to the
control your movement.
Buying beer with IEDs, I don't even look like.
Let's do another 3.
But we never care.
2, 1, the hip area, release tension, and then we're going to roll over to the other side, so we're going to move the band back up, so your time to set up, we're going to go do the clamshell first, bend both knees, keep the feet together. Open shut. Let's do another 3, 2, and 1. Release, tap, tap, tap. And then we're gonna roll down, lie down on your back. So take your time to come lie down on your back. We're gonna move the band further up to the thigh again. And then by your side. Release the spine down, keeping the natural curve in your lower back. Close your eyes for a moment. Let your body get used to lying on its back, and we're going to get ready for the bridge pose. Press firmly on the mat when you're ready. On the inhale, we lift the hips high, high up.
Exhale to lower down. One more breath at a time. So continue. Inhale one way. Exhale the other. Engage your core abdominal muscles. Your quadriceps and your glutes are firm. So in another word, squeeze the stomach in tight. Your thighs and your butt are firm. Strengthening the front abdominal muscles and the lower back muscles to support your spine. Now bridge poses if you want to do, for those who have back pain, but we probably need to do it more repetition, more regularly. When you're ready, on the inhale, we're going to lift the hand chest up. Reach for the toes. Exhale to lower everything down. So continue. Inhale to lift the hand chest up. Use the abdominal muscles. So try not to come up with your neck muscles here. If you cannot touch the toes, reach for any part of the legs. Let's do another three, two, and one. Slowly, inhale back down. Going to do some leg lift. Take a breath here. First round. Lower down for 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. When your legs are 1 foot off the ground, don't drop it. Bend both knees, lifting the legs back up to the sky. Take a breath here. Another round. Nice and slowly control. Don't just swing the leg up and down. We're using our core abdominal muscle for this. Stabilize your legs with the fan. Let's do two more rounds. Control your movement. No need to speed up. And one last one. Now we're going to stay here. One feet off the ground. Lifting the head chest up. Come on, your forearms. We're going to pause it here. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly release everything down. Catch your breath. And when you're ready, we're going to lift the legs back up to the sky. And we're going to do open chest, small letter movement. Forward, backwards.
I miss the thunder. I miss your warm lips like the summer. I was the rain, you were the cover. You held me up and up.
Let's do another three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Now we're going to remove the loop band. Reach for the long resistor band. We'll place it on one leg. So I'm using my left leg. I'm going to leave it all the way down on the mat first. And we're going to slowly, with control, lift the left leg up to the sky. Point the right toes up to the ceiling so both legs are working. Stretching out the hamstring here. If you have very tight hamstrings, slightly bend the knee. So know your range of motion and your back foot. When you're ready, you're going to walk up. Pull yourself up. Stay here for a moment. Make sure you're not carrying tension in your neck, shoulders, or upper back.
You love me blind, I love you reckless.
One more breath and then slowly release the head down. Right hand, so opposite hand, guiding the top leg close to the floor. So the hips automatically comes off. We're coming into a spinal twist. Shoulder and shoulder blade are still on the mat. Left arm out, shoulder height, palm facing down. Turn over the left side of your neck stick. Stretch, strengthen, and tone the lower back muscles to support your spine, especially if you have back pain. One more breath, and we slowly, slowly bring this top leg back to center. Switching hands, same hand, grab hold of that. And we're going to lower it to the other side. So we can come to a wide leg. Open up your foot, stretching out in the side. Only go to where you're comfortable. Now make sure the other hip's on the mat. So I'm using my right hand on the hip area, keeping the right hip down. A little bit of discomfort here. One more breath, and I'm just slowly bring this leg back and set it. Remove the band, nice and slow, take control. I'm going to remove the left leg band, switching sides. So I'm going to place the resistant band on the right leg. So I'm going to lower it down on the mat first. When you're ready, lift the right leg up towards the sky. Hamstring stretch.
I know he's just.
If you have very tight hamstrings, slightly bend the knee. You know your range of motion.
But I see it on your face when you say that he's the one that you want.
Taking a few breaths.
You spend the night in this wrong situation, and anytime you want it to stop.
When you're ready, you can walk the hands up. One more breath, I'm going to lower up the body down. Opposite hand, guiding softly, as close to the floor as possible. Hips automatically comes up. Bring our mouth shoulder height, palm facing down. Turn over to the right side and I just
everything I need, this could be so different. Tell me what you want to do. Cause I know I can treat you better.
Stretching our lower back muscle. Creating space. Between our core and our five. Helping people to reach back.
Tell me what you want to do. You should be with me instead. I know I can treat you better.
One more breath. Let's go slowly. Slowly. Back like center, switching hands. Same hand, grab hold of that, and lift it slowly. Lower it to the right side. You see my left hand on the left hip? Keeping the hip down, because I don't want to lift the hip off the ground. Opening up hip joint, stretching out inner thighs. Maybe a little bit of discomfort.
Promise I'll never let you down.
Those who have yoga blocks handy can also rest the right foot on the yoga block.
He can't pin any guy like you deserves a
one more breath.
Tell me why I'll
slowly be slowly guide your right leg back to the center. Placing both legs, both feet into your once again, we are stretching hamstring on both sides. Now, when you're ready, we're going to lower both legs down to the mat. So, feel the resistance here. Just going to bring it up to the sky again. Take a breath and lower down. One last one. Slowly, slowly, curl back up. Opening up the legs in a big V. So hold on to the handle of your resistant band. Go to where you're comfortable. Opening up your joints. And we're going to pull the legs close to your body. It's rocking forward, backwards. Stretching out your thighs. Opening up your joints. Only open as wide as you're comfortable. Let's do another three. Two. One, come back to center, rocking it side to side.
Do you have room?
Touch down on the floor. Massaging the entire spine and fire back. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Bring the legs together. Remove the long bend. Nice and slow control. We're gonna release the legs back down on the mat. Getting ready to come up. So you get knees bent. Roll over to the right side. Make your pillow on the right tricep. Come lie down this side for a minute. And when you're ready, you should have arm to push yourself up. And we're gonna come to a neutral tabletop. Spread all your fingers, wrists underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hip, up and sit on the mat, neutral spine. When you're ready, you're gonna go into cat-cow. Inhale, cross your legs, chin up, and up, move to the mat. Exhale, round your back as much as you can. Pull your back and head, put it down into the cat. So we're gonna do this a few times. And your own breath, and your own pace. Inhale, one way. Exhale, the other. Connecting your breath with your creating spaces between your breaks. Two more times. And one last one. Slowly, slowly come back to center, sway side to side, release tension in your wrist. Take an inhale, center, exhale, travel over the right hips. Squeeze the shoulder and hip together. Inhale, center, exhale to the other side, forming a C shape in your spine. One more set. Inhale, center, exhale. Inhale, center, exhale to the left. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Sway side to side. Sit back into your child pose. Lengthening the spine. Walking the fingers forward. Neck and spine in one straight line. Keep any tension that you may have in your wrist. One more breath. And we get ready to come up. Meet you in down dog. Spread out your fingers with your knees. Lift your hips high, high up. Coming into a down dog. Inhale from the mat, on the earth to the toes. Exhale, lower the hip back down. One more time. Inhale, up, on the toes. Exhale down. Inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale, down dog. Again, inhale, come forward to plank. Not sticking the bottom, not sliding. Exhale, to that dog. Couple more times, inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale, to that dog. Two more times. Inhale to plank. Exhale, one last one. Inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale. Slowly walk forward. What's the hand? Come into a forward bend. Dangle here from the wrist. Leg is gonna rest on the thighs. If you can touch the mat, touch the mat. If you cannot touch the mat, go on to opposite out. Lengthening the spine. Stretching our lower back muscles. Let the blood go the other way. Just be mindful that head is below enough. So if you don't feel good about this, you need to slowly come out. One more breath. You're again ready to come up. Hands on waist with the ball. Inhale, halfway up to the front half. Exhale. Slowly, slowly, rise up to standing.
Let your blood pressure get adjusted. Once you come all the way up,
back bend count. Interlace the fingers. Knuckles down and away from you. Lifting chin up and high back.
Now pushing the hips forward. Shoulders and hips are level.
Improving your posture. Shine your chest up to the ceiling. Expanding lung capacity. Stimulating thigh one time. One more breath. Slowly, slowly squeeze. Shake that.
If you're around the shoulder roll,
release any tension that you may have. Go the other way. And then for the breath, the long resistance.
Place both feet into the bed. Adjust the length. Now we're going to go into the chair pose. So let's get this movement going. We're not squeezing the thigh together and not sitting the butt up. So up and down first. And when you're ready, we'll do single. Single. Feel the resistance. If you need more bend, shorten your stand.
One last single. Keep going up and down. Double. Don't push the knee beyond your toes. Slightly tuck the tailbone in. You protect your back. You don't have to go very far down. Let's do another three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly. Step in the back and on your back and give your side views. When you're ready, we're going to extend. Into a warrior stand. So single first. Extend. Two. And one. Side. Soft knees, don't rock your knees. Let's do another three. Two. One. Slowly release. Placing both feet into the band again, crisscross. When you're ready, up to the shoulder height. Let's do another three, two, and one. Very good. Release. Switching side. Shorten your band as you can eat. Shift the weight to the standing leg. Square the hip to the front. Bring up the other leg. Smaller, okay? Feel the resistance. Working on your glutes, the big muscle. Make sure that you don't squeeze it so much that you're cramping. Tight. Chin is away from the bottom. No pain forward.
opening up your joints, stretching out inner thighs. Let's do another three. Two. One. Slowly, slowly, please. Now we're going to grab the loop back. Place both legs into your bag. So this is the standing version. Inside leg is the standing leg. Holding onto your chair. Lift up the other leg. Outside hand on your waist. Small, little movement. Now those who wish to further challenge themselves, holding on to opposite elbows. Now I find that this is challenging, so I personally have to hold on. Try your best. Walking the standing leg and ankle. Conversations with your abs intact. Don't forget to breathe. Let's do another three. Two. And one. Inside. Shift the weight to standing leg. So I'm doing this. Let's do have a fun three. Slowly, slowly release. So now we're going to come sit down. So have all your equipment close by. So we already have the band on our sides. So let's just sit here for a moment. Sitting up nice and tall. Let your body get used to sitting down first. Shoulders are relaxed. And when you're ready, we're going to go open, toes are pulling it out. In, toes are pulling it in. Open, shut. Now the loop band may not be as powerful, as tight as the resistant band. And if you feel like you can move up to the next strength level, go ahead. Stomach on top. Stomach and chest proud, shoulder on top of hips. Sitting up nice and tall. Good posture always. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Take a breath here, move the band down. Adjust your posture, sitting up nice and tall. You can either have the hands on the thigh or holding onto the chair for support. Your choice. Now we're going to inhale up, exhale down. Not kicking. Use your core abdominal muscles for this. Walking the entire leg from the hip joint to your ankle joint. Point your toes up to the ceiling. Stretching our hamstring. Now we're working this big muscle, the quadriceps. Pass. Stretching our hamstring, ankle joint. Let's do another four. Three. Two. And one, sit up tall, open, shut. Small and open, shut. Control your movement. Let's do another four. Three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Frame. One leg out. The other one. Place the foot on your back. So it depends on how tall you are. Maybe long breath. Inhale up, exhale. Sitting up nice and tall. So we will get this motion going first. And then we go up, open, close, and down. Inhale up, straight, open, close, and down. So knee up, extend, open, close, and down. Knee up, extend, open, close, and down. Continue, knee up, extend, open, close, and down. Now when you're in the wide leg, feel the stretch in the inner thighs, opening up hip joints. So know your range of motion, only open as big as you're comfortable.
Away from the body, don't move forward.
It was a wicked and wild. Let's do a few more. Just be mindful that over time your bends break due to wear and tear, so just be careful. One last one. So then release to chest side. Take your time to set up. Opposite hand, opposite shoulder.
Ready? Pull it up.
come to a cool down segment now. We're gonna come to a twist. Inhale, your arms up, lengthening. Exhale, give yourself a hug. Opposite hand, opposite shoulder. Wrap the back arm around your waist. Keep turning, overlooking your shoulder, looking at the back. Inhale, your arms up, we're lengthening the spine, the center. Exhale, twist, give yourself a hug. Opposite hand, opposite shoulder. Wrap the back arm around your waist. Slowly, slowly come back to center. And we're going to do a few round of wind releasing on the right side. Wrap your hands around the right knee. Draw closer, chest, arm, hips. Now, whatever you do, don't lean back. There's no support in your lower back. Come and squeeze. Be gentle. Massaging organs on the right side as well as the sending colon. So, my back is your right. The side, wrap the hands around the other knee, draw closer to the chest or armpits, gently pump it a few times. Massaging organs on the left side as well as descending colon. Anytime you feel bloated, constipated, you can try this and see if it brings you pain. Into figure four, opposite ankle, opposite thigh, flex the foot to protect the knee. Make sure both butts are sitting down, hand resting on the thigh, slightly lean forward. You're going to immediately feel the stretch here. Hip flexor, opening your hip joint, helping people to relieve sciatic condition. So don't put your entire body weight on this. You adjust your own tension, your own intensity. Slowly release, get a side. So once again, if you have severe sciatic condition, you should be seeking professional medical help to get diagnosis and treatments. Slowly, slowly, release, come back to center. Raise the legs a finger, press it down. Push the sky away. Front stretch, shoulder exercise. We come to side bend, outside hand level with the inside wrist, chins away from the body, looking up. Inhale, lift, exhale to the other side. Outside hand, grab with the inside wrist. Chin is away from the body, breathing up. Inhale, center, one more set. Exhale to the right, release the bottom arm. Come on, is impressive. Get a little bit deeper in your side bend. Inhale, outside, lift, exhale to the other side. Release the bottom arm. The top arm is impressive. Slowly, slowly come back up. Come down. So we've come to the end of the workout. Thank you very much for joining us, sharing your energy with all of us, and letting me guide through this workout. Always my pleasure.